All right, let's bring up the item number 3 and 4, the follow-up on the Austin Police Department handling of complaints, and then 4 was the effectiveness of citizen police oversight audit. So whichever order y'all would like to bring those.
Certainly, we'll do the follow-up. It's very short, and then the effectiveness of citizen oversight. The follow-up was conducted by Olga Ovcharenko, our quality assurance coordinator, and the lead was JoJo Cruz. And JoJo will be presenting this morning.
Good morning, council members, mayor. Like Corey said, I'm JoJo, and I will be presenting to you the results of the follow-up of audit recommendations for the APD handling of complaints audit report. We issued the audit report in September 2016 with 11 recommendations. Management agreed to implement our recommendations with the exception of one regarding documenting the justification for discipline. We tested the 10 recommendations management agreed to. We noted that the labor agreement negotiations this year affected the implementation of some of the recommendations. Overall, 6 of the recommendations we tested have been fully implemented by management, while 4 recommendations are still underway. For the 3 recommendations listed on the slide, management has made significant progress, but the implementation will depend on the outcome of the labor agreement negotiations. For recommendation 10, which relates to addressing data reliability, the police department continues to work with CTM to make improvements to the internal affairs system of records. This concludes my presentation, and we are happy to answer your questions.
Great. Thanks so much. Questions? Councilmember Halter.
So number 7 was not agreed to by management, so it wasn't tested, correct? Mm-hmm. It's my understanding that this was all done originally under a prior chief?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you speak a little bit more to what number 7 was?
Well, I believe management is here, and they can probably answer that question better.
Okay, because what I was wondering is whether the new chief would be willing to take another look at that recommendation now that he is officially in place to determine whether that is something that might be of benefit.
That's great. So let's go ahead and see if there's any other questions for staff, and then we'll have the management response, and they can go directly to your question. Mayor, did you have any questions you wanted to ask?
With respect to this?
Just the staff presentation at this point. Okay, great. All right.
Just to clarify real quick before we turn it over to APD, the original question was that the police chief implement a process to document justifications for discipline, including how disagreements with the police monitor are addressed. So that was the original.
Good morning.
Morning.
Chris McElvain. I'm an assistant chief of the Austin Police Department, IRC, our headquarters bureau, which includes the Internal Affairs Division. When this original recommendation was reviewed, Chief Acevedo, again, was leading the department at that time. He felt that the suspension memos, disciplinary memos that were issued at the conclusion of a sustained complaint were sufficient in documenting the justification for said discipline. As far as any controversy or disagreements between recommendations by the OPM and management, he felt those were best handled in discussions and meetings rather than actually having them documented. That being said, this has not been revisited with Chief Manley since he has taken over the Austin Police Department. So I know that he has reviewed this, and he has not put forth any recommendations other than what was already put forth. But if we need to revisit that with him, we certainly can.
I'm not sure what the appropriate procedure is, but I would like to ask him to revisit that now that he's chief.
Absolutely.
See if there's an appropriate way forward to implement that recommendation.
Absolutely.
Or if he concurs with Mr. Acevedo.
Just to provide an additional perspective on that, why I think it's important. When we were looking at the questions on oversight that were coming back to the council last December, after the contract came forward, there were some folks in the community that wanted to prescribe the process for handling the suggestions that came and the responses coming from the department. And there was some question at the time as to whether or not that was an appropriate thing or an allowable thing or a correct thing, and whether that kind of provision needed to go in the contract or didn't need to go into the contract. But it seemed to me that the issue that was that had arisen was that the public, even if there was an informal conversation, the public wouldn't know. They would know about the recommendation that came from the commission, but they wouldn't know how it was resolved. So it looked like there was no response to the resolution, even if there had been a response to the resolution. So one of the things that some of the council offices were discussing back in December, had we moved forward with the contract, was trying to institutionalize a process where if a suggestion was made, the police chief, in responding to it, could provide a report to the council, even saying, I've gotten this recommendation, and I either said yes or I said no, and this was the basis I said yes or no. And that was an oversight function that the council could do that in that instance might have obviated the need for there to be a contract change or procedure change. But certainly if it was something that the chief did on his own and made public, then there might not be even the need to have that regular reporting coming back to the council. But my sense is that because there's not a way to fix, to do that loop without some kind of public response and disclosure, that's probably a direction that I would like to see, and I think there are some other council members who would like to see that too.
Absolutely, and as you know, we're in contract negotiations currently, so that will be something I'll brief the law department on as well as we sort of move forward to see where the appropriateness of that is once I gauge that question with Chief Manley.
My thought was is that, and we had figured out we could do that outside of the contract negotiations. The council could just ask for a report, you know, from the manager, saying to the manager, hey, by the way, when you get recommendations from that task force, would you please report back to us what the recommendation was and what the response was? So my sense was we could just do that.
Okay.
Understood. Would be great if the chief just did that.
All right. I will have that discussion with Chief Manley.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think I would amplify that to say that it would be really good. That way you can create a record so that 3 years down the road, someone who wants to know, well, what happened with that issue or that complaint, they could go back and read what the report said. It would be important for the council to know what kinds of complaints are coming forward and how they're being resolved. But there really is nothing to take the place of a written record. And I'm glad to know that was the approach previously, so that we can come in and indicate that at least I feel really strongly that we need to have I understand Chief Acevedo preferring a face-to-face verbal discussion, but if you don't capture the essence of those verbal discussions, it is as if they have never happened with regard to anybody else knowing or even understanding what they were, because people have different interpretations of what is being said. So for clarity and for, frankly, for official record-keeping purposes, I would think that it would be incumbent on us to capture that information. So going forward, I join my colleagues in saying I think that would be an improvement that the police department could make, and I also agree that I think they could do it without having specific direction by way of the city manager in form of a resolution to do it. That seems just good management practices. Councilmember Alto.
I would like to make a motion to approve the audit with instructions to request the Chief Manley revisit item number 7 and either report back to Audit and Finance or to the council about how he might proceed to fulfill that recommendation.
Mayor?
Second.
I think what I'd like to say is instead of one or the other, send it to Audit and Finance, and then it will also go to the council.
That's fine.
So that there's no question about that. All right. Is that okay?
Sure.
All right. So we will vote on approving this follow-up audit with the amendment from Council Member Alter saying that she would like to have a response on item 7 from Chief Manley on implementing a process to document justifications for discipline, including how disagreements with the police monitor are addressed. All in favor? And that is unanimous. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
All right. So that was number 3.